For centuries, investigators have attempted to uncover the secrets of the Freemasons. The threads, codes, and revelations all appear to connect at a single location. America's capital. The quest for the truth behind the most powerful secret society in the world begins here in Washington. A city built by Freemasons for Freemasons, with Masonic secrets and codes embedded in every iconic structure.
One of the major traditions in Masonry is the expression hidden in plain sight. If you really know what to look for in Washington, the Masonic tradition is there to see.
From the Washington Monument to the Capitol building to the secret foundation stones of the city itself, Washington, D.C. is said to contain Masonic codes known only to the initiated.
What's fascinating there is the information is being conveyed in many ways other than words, other than text, through an array of symbolic illustrations, paintings that had specific meaning.
Before one can interpret and understand the codes, one needs to understand the origins of the organization that put them there. The Freemasons are an organization with an enigmatic past, a shadowy membership, and mysterious goals.
It is not a social club. It is not a civic club. Definitely, it's not a religious organization. And it's not a charity.
The mystery surrounding the Freemasons originates from the levels of secrecy associated with it throughout history. Few other organizations require blindfolded initiations, blood oaths, or codes and symbols for identification. This reenactment shows details of the initiation of a master mason. In the first stage of initiation, the newcomer is blindfolded, his clothes stripped away. He then swears never to reveal the Masonic secrets. In the final stage, the master reenacts a death and resurrection ritual with the initiate himself as the stand-in human sacrifice.
The initiation is an esoteric process that conveys through the language of symbolism powerful concepts and presents the individual with tools that he would use in order to improve himself.
With the initiation now complete, it's claimed the Freemason is now a changed man.
It's really an internal transformation of who you are by developing greater awareness of the physical, the intellectual, and spiritual world in which you live.
And if the initiate reveals any of its mysteries, the penalty is severe. The Masonic vow promises the oathbreaker will suffer a slashed throat, disembowelment, and being burned alive. The Freemasons' commitment to secrecy is what differentiates them from simply being a local Rotary Club or church group. There are three levels in basic Freemasonry: Entered Apprentice, Fellow Craft, and Master Mason. At each successive level, a Freemason is given increased access to the organization's hidden codes. There are further levels, also known as degrees, and further Masonic organizations to join: the Scottish Rite, the York Rite, the Shriners, each with their own oaths and codes. Scottish Rite Freemasonry has 33 degrees. And the number 33 repeatedly appears as a code for the highest of secrets. But only Masons know what the code means. For Freemasons, secrecy serves a vital purpose.
Secrecy is a symbol, like everything else in Freemasonry is. It's a symbol of our honor. If you can't be trusted to keep a handshake or a password a secret, then you're really not a very trustworthy person.
We insist on secrets to teach the person silence. Silence is key in Freemasonry. When one is speaking, one does not learn. One needs to be silent, to absorb. Second reason for silence, it teaches the Mason to keep a trust. If I cannot keep my brother's trust to myself, I lose it.
This shroud of secrecy is why some religious organizations accuse Freemasonry of promoting deception, political treason, atheism, even Satanism.
Freemasons have a reputation among evangelical Christians and others as being somehow satanic or practicing the dark arts. And you wonder, did the Freemasons themselves put out this cover story as a way to perhaps enhance the mystique of the organization?
Freemasonry remains an esoteric society. Esoteric sounds like it means the same thing as a cult, and it doesn't. Esoteric simply means knowledge held by a group of people. It is not for outsiders.
Freemasons state their mysteries can only be experienced, not revealed. What can be revealed is the symbolic equipment and sacred objects inside a Freemason's lodge. Objects rooted in one of the most ancient trades in history.
Take a look around a lodge room. Look at what you're seeing. You are seeing the symbols of stone cutters, masons, builders. You're seeing the square and compass. You are seeing a maul hammer. You're seeing trowels. These are all symbols of builders.
These ritual tools hint at the secret society's origins. The 12th century. Europe experienced a revolution in architecture. Innovations like the flying buttress allowed buildings to be larger, taller, and more airy. Cities began competing to build great cathedrals. And from this revolution came a group of builders, stonemasons, who jealously protected their trade secrets.
A Freemason was very secretive. He never wrote down the sacred geometry of his craft. He never wrote down how he had learned it. He learned it as an entered apprentice in what was called the lodge. And the knowledge came from the master mason. He was the free mason. He was free to move from place to place, from job to job.
These roving Freemasons would only discuss their trade with members of the same guild, who were recognized by secret handshakes and coded phrases. Yet some claim the society is older still.
I think part of the mystery about Freemasonry is its connection with the ancient world. Their roots are traced as far back as the Egyptian mysteries of Isis and Osiris.
It goes all the way back to Imhotep of Egypt. Imhotep was the first great architect about 2800 BC. He was the grand vizier for the pharaoh Zoser. He built the Step Pyramid. He was also a doctor, a poet, and he was one of the only men who was not a pharaoh, who became a god.
Pyramid symbols are found throughout Freemasonry, in the structure of lodges, the ritual icons, even on the openly Masonic Great Seal of the United States, printed on every American dollar bill.